It's 500 miles to Dayton. It was dark when I started. It's not now. I have an almost full tank of gas, and I'm wearing glasses. Ham Radio Now episode, I'm not sure what, but I know what I'm going to call it. The Dayton 500. Hit it. And we're on the road. Yes, I'm wearing that headset. Yay, finally. And I think I've got, well, I'll show you. I'll do a little B-roll and show you the setup. But yeah, the audio should be good. One little glitch. I'm not sure how this is happening, but as I turn my head, you can hear a little alternator whine, the kind that infects some mobile radios. And the microphone is sensitive to position when I do that. If I turn, turning my head is just turning the microphone. So that's why it changes. I've got the microphone positioned so that when I'm looking straight ahead, it's kind of minimized, kind of nulled out. But if I turn, like, especially to the left, I think you can hear it. It's not real loud, but I think you can hear it. Let's see. Yeah, the picture looks good. And it is 7:55, but it should take me about 8 hours to get there. I want to get there before the offices close, the media office, so I can pick up my credentials. And that means I got to keep the pedal to the metal. An unusual thing for me. No Jeff on this trip. Jeff has a real daytime job and is beating his butt, so he's unable to go this year and he's not happy about it. I've also got an elaborate audio setup in addition to having the headset mic. I have a little field mixer and I've stuck it in here. So the HF rig, the 7000, is plugged directly into the mixer. And let me, I'm listening to 40 meters right now. I was kind of hoping to check into mid-cars. No signals from them. Maybe they haven't started yet. Maybe they don't start till 8, which would be 7 their time. Most Midwest. Yeah, it sounds like East Cars is up and running.
All right, dude, Dave. Have a great one down there. And, you know, if all else fails, you can always go up on the tower and fly kite.
So we'll check in there. It's not an official trip until I've checked in. Whoa. Ah, there's a guy I know.
Have a great one, Dave.
But I can't hear him. Or maybe he's not transmitting. Maybe he went away. So I'll check in there in a moment. Maybe not. Alpha Quebec Mobile.
Mobile ending in Quebec. Good morning.
Good morning, Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile. My name is Gary, located just outside of Raleigh, North Carolina, and I have 500 miles to go, so guess where I'm going?
Let me take a guess. Central Ohio?
Central Western Ohio, but yeah, you got the general direction right, so we're on the way.
Have a great big trip there, Gary.
73. Okay, so that worked. Cool. We'll tune in again in a little bit, see if they get some more mobiles heading out there. Let's see, what else have I got set up here? I've got the 2820 and plugged into my mobile laptop, which is just outside of camera range, is a DVAP. And I've got my Nexus Google Fi Nexus phone. Here's something that's, I don't know, is this unique to North Carolina? And all the radios are kind of blocking the guy. When I grew up in Illinois, and most other places I've been, if you've got a green light and there's no turn arrow, which is unusual anymore, most intersections have turn arrows. When you get the green light and you're waiting for oncoming traffic to clear, you get out in the intersection. So the guy behind you can also get out in the intersection so that if it's like this, nobody's going to go until the light turns yellow. And two cars, maybe three cars, can go on the yellow light. But here in North Carolina, nobody pulls out into the intersection. Well, we got an arrow anyway, so kind of irrelevant. Makes my rant a little bit less effective, but people don't pull out. Of course, there aren't that many lights that don't have a protected left turn anyway. And, good. I'm heading into rush hour traffic immediately. So this isn't going to help. So I've got the 2820 set on with a DVAP, and I've got the 2820 in echo mode. Let's see. Oh, the mic is turned up. I can leave them. The 7000 is connected directly. The 2820, its audio connections are harder to get to, so I just have a microphone set there. I can turn it down, but for the moment, echo test, KN4AQ, echo testing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Echo test.
Oh, fine. Garbling into my own DVAP. Garbling into my DVAP. KN4AQ testing.
Garbling into my DVAP. KN4AQ testing.
Still not very far outside of town. It's 8:22 in the morning. Let's do a little propagation check. Let's see what's going on out there. The 10 megahertz WWV, though, is not very strong, so that's actually surprising. 10 megahertz anytime. Kind of a go-to sweet spot. Now my antenna is set for 40 meters, which will attenuate 10 megahertz a little bit, but my experience is that if the signal's strong, you're usually going to hear it pretty well. And there it is, but it's not doing anything on the meter. 15 megahertz, nothing. Send the antenna down that way just for fun, just to make sure. But the old sunspot cycle, the previous one, hung in there longer than I expected it to. But, and I haven't been scouring the bands every day, but the times I do check, the higher frequencies have punked out a lot. They'll still show up now and then. I've been reading a lot more Reddit, and on there you're seeing a lot of comments from new hams, and it makes me realize I've got to orient my thinking if I want to especially talk to new hams, and that's not what I specialize in, but if I want to talk to new hams, there's a lot of stuff that I have to back up on and realize people don't have any clue. Well, this is cool. I'm thinking that there's a tower over there. It's actually owned by a local repeater group, and they make most of their money by leasing out space on that tower. It's not a real tall tower, but I'm up on the top of a pretty big hill, and I thought it was sticking up into the clouds, but it's not. It's just a very gray day. So understanding the concept of this 11-year sunspot cycle is something I've got to keep in mind. Not everybody does. And even if they know that the 11-year sunspot cycle exists, they don't really know what its effect is. It is highly erratic, but you can get some trends. And one of them is that for the next few years, the frequencies above 20 megahertz, even 15 megahertz are not going to be very usable many days or many hours in any given day. 20 meters probably still be open almost every day during the day, but it will close down at night. 17 meters open up, a little less than 20 does. And then 15, 12, and 10, you can expect them to have pretty much dead conditions almost all the time, but not all the time. And some of it, the case is going to be that there's just nobody, the band's open, nobody's using it. But, yeah, nothing on 20 megahertz. Oh, there's the 15 megahertz signal. Again, not real strong. I got the antenna around that spot. The 10 megahertz is coming up a little bit. My old school propagation check. So let's see, I was going to connect the DVAP to local reflector, and I actually had it connected and then it disappeared. Let me turn up its microphone.
Remote system linked.
KN4AQ Mobile, listening reflector 54C. I've connected to a quote local unquote reflector. It's dedicated to the Carolinas, reflector 54. No reflector is truly local, they're all on the internet. You can reach them from anywhere you can reach the internet. But many reflectors have some localization to them. So the Google 5 phone is acting as a hotspot. It's also acting as my map. But it's acting as a hotspot, pulling data from the cellular network. And then the computer sitting over here has the DVAP software running on it. And then the 2820 is talking to the DVAP. KN4AQ echo testing.
KN4AQ.
I don't like that. That shouldn't happen on a local echo test. That probably indicates that I'm going to sound pretty bad through the reflectors as well. Well, we're here, let's just dial over to 60 meters because I like seeing if there's any activity going on. It's still going to be open a little bit. Oh, yeah. People talking on channel 4. Nobody on 3, nobody on 2, nobody on 1. But I can't really see what I'm doing, but this clicking is using ICOM's system for making a little graph. You might be able to see the graph. Block the reflection on the display. You might be able to see the graph a little bit that it makes as I click, just a quick little click, and it jumps certain amount of spectrum. I got it set for 10 kilohertz on these low frequencies because the antenna is so high Q. Its bandwidth is real narrow, so I want to see very carefully what I'm tuned to. and not step over what it's tuned to. The bandwidth at 60 meters is about 15, 20 kilohertz wide at most. And you click the microphone and it sends a little burst of energy, measures the SWR, puts it on the graph, and jumps the radio up whatever spectrum amount that you have set. And you can set it for a certain number of times. I think I got it set for 10, which gives a good display and creates a graph. And you can see where the resonant point is on the antenna and make a quick adjustment and try it again. Easy to do.
Joe's in the same boat right now, so I think he's got a little more or nothing with him. And let's see, what did I say his name was? Rich down in Mississippi has been here too. Let me pass it to him and let him say hi for a second. Go ahead, AF5AU.
Hi, Roger, Bill. It's AF5AU.
All right, so I'm getting some idea where the spectrum is working, Mississippi to North Carolina. But signals are not real strong, as they often are not on 60 meters, because nobody's running more than 100 watts. 60 meters is your 100 watts on a wire band. And that reminds me, attention, Christian. I think he got bent out of shape. At 85 watts in a wire. And that was not my intention. I just wanted to poke some fun. It happened at a bad time because he lost Katie, and there's a bunch of call signs that have disappeared from that show. I hear rumors that it's not all quite as sweetness and light as one might hope, that people just got busy or had to do other things. I have not confirmed the rumors, so. Happy to repeat them. I guess this will be TMZ. So I don't know. But I still like the show. I like listening to Kristen. He works better with a partner. He worked great with Katie. But he does a good job solo. I work better with a partner, but I do a good enough job solo. But he did the episode with Pearl Jam in the title. And sounds like he was a little miffed. He still didn't say ham radio now. He said other media, other shows. So he's never going to say the name of my show. And there's a sort of a traditional broadcastery reason for that. Not just broadcasting, politics and stuff. If you're the guy on top, you don't want to mention the competition. You never do. And he's got a bigger audience than I do, so in a sense he's on top. If you're the guy trying to get attention and scrapping and struggling, which is, believe it or not, that's the case for ham radio now. Our audience isn't great. You guys are very loyal, and you love these on-the-road programs, so I'll get a big audience for this one. But, he claims an audience of 8,000 to 10,000 or so, and I'm seeing an audience of, depends on the show. Some shows get into that esoteric, rarefied air, but most of them are in a couple of thousand. I can now see the audio downloads. Couldn't see them before. So we'll see how they're doing. In any case, I'll consider his program to be more popular than mine, which means that I'll mention his name a lot. He thanked me obliquely for sending some more people to listen to his show. Maybe I did. Anyway, Christian, I'm not bent out of shape, and I hope you're not. I was just poking fun. And if there is more to this stuff about people having not appearing or being mentioned on your program, you really ought to own up to it. You give the impression of someone who is going to tell it like it is. And then if you don't explain what's really going on, then you lose credibility. I try to keep everything above board. Stop! Oh, no. Don't worry. That's not a brick wall. Well, it is a brick wall in front of me. But, it's, because I'm at a gas station. Stop to reconfigure the microphones and stuff a little bit. And, and, you know, do the essentials. I didn't need gas, not yet. Trying to find my way out. I had plugged the headset mic into the camera directly, thinking that that would make the noise go away, that alternator whine. And I was surprised that it didn't. So I plugged it back into the mixer and did some reconfiguring. I can hear myself a little better this way. And hearing myself a little bit better, I think I hear the alternator whine more, but I don't know if it's getting into the camera more. I don't think so. In any case, I think I'm okay. I also took the opportunity to reorient the face of the radio a little bit, so I think you can see the display now. It's tiny, but high def, I think you can probably see it. There's that SWR chart I was talking about. So before we leave this territory, I'm going to send the antenna back down toward 20 meters and sweep across the spectrum.
About 20 miles north of the
10 megahertz, doing better. 15 megahertz. Nothing again for the moment, anyway. Now there it comes. Now the antenna is getting into its range. Oh, actually getting pretty strong. Maybe I better pay more attention to where the antenna is before I do a propagation test, I guess. Because it's pretty strong. Anything on 20 megahertz? No. Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Roger.
Roger, you are 5555 Mobile in North Carolina. My name is Gary.
Okay, 555 North Carolina. You're seeing a report 555 also from Venezuela, Bay 73. Thank you.
73.
Thank you very much.
So decided to tune around a little bit, see what was going on, and boom, there he was, and he wasn't talking to anybody, just calling CQ Venezuela.
73, thank you.
So let's rock the propagation knob around a little bit. Whoa, big signal on 15 megahertz S9 plus. Traffic is getting dicey here. Yes, I do every once in a while look out the window and see what's going on. So we may see 20 megahertz open up later on today. I don't know. We'll see. I'm curious, with 15 so strong, is it hitting up to 18? Let's take a gander across 17 meters. Somebody way down there.
Very good morning. Thanks for coming back to the call. I see we went before, Jerry. I see we went before.
This is what that SWR thing looks like, as I'm stepping across just to make sure.
After more than 5 years, I do have a good copy on you. I will give you an exact report on your next over, but Q5 copy.
S0.
Michael, Ocean, Norway, 7, Hotel, Juliet, Alpha. The handle is Johan, Juliet, Oscar, Hotel, Alpha, November. This is here in the northeast part of Belgium. We are about 10 miles from the border of the Netherlands and about 15 miles from the border of the
I was right by there not too long ago. Wow, that seems, that trip seems a blur now. I've been going over the video from it. The previous Ham Radio Now episode with almost no ham radio in it had, that trip documented and they added the video. That was a fun recording and sounded better than I thought it would, recording it on the microphone just on the Nexus phone with Cindy. And Cindy, by the way, has a future in podcasting if she wants it. She's very good, very natural. She did Toastmasters. She's been president of a radio club, you know, stood up in front of all those people and had to talk extemporaneously. But she's particularly good doing podcasts. It's too bad she doesn't really care about ham radio. Or she could be good. Google's telling me I should be paying attention to the road ahead, which I am. So, okay, so there's that guy on 17 meters. So I haven't tried calling him. But he's pretty weak. Okay, 18-120. We'll come back there in a moment. I'm almost hearing the guy he was talking to. I don't know, with a signal that weak, I don't hold out a lot of hope of being able to get through to him, but I'll give it a try. Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile. Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile.
The radio, Uniform Whiskey again.
And that wasn't me.
Roger, is it Whiskey Delta 8, Radio Uniform Whiskey? Jim, is that you? Roger, I wasn't sure if I had the last...
Turn the preamp on. Not really, because it really makes signals snap out of the noise. I find that it doesn't. I just wanted a little more volume from him. He's so weak.
Very, very strong this afternoon. The band is open, but today. But anyway, thanks for the call. Nice to hear you again. I knew he was twice, but that was quite some time ago. So good to hear you again.
Putting the preamp on bounces him up to about S1. So we'll stick with him for another go round and try one more time. But it's kind of nice that he's not making just wham bam contacts. He's talking a little bit. And whoever he's talking to, we're not hearing them at all. If you're looking out the window, it's getting stronger. A little QSB, so maybe we'll have a chance. So if you're looking out the window, you can't see much because it's cloudy. But I'm approaching the Blue Ridge Mountains. It's getting hilly here, and we'll go up a really steep incline in a little bit. I don't know why I have a camera with it when we do it, but we'll gain a lot of altitude.
Hope to work you again, and hopefully we don't have to wait another 5 years before we can do it again.
Computer logging
Carolina from Ocean, Norway.
Okay, so yeah, I'm not going to hear a guy in South Carolina. So now the quandary is, do I call him now or do I wait for him to give me a clue that he's listening? Because South Carolina guy's probably saying something back to him.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec. I think I missed the last letter of the suffix. Can you please try one more time?
You got it correct. Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile in North Carolina.
Roger. Yeah, I did copy that. Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile in North Carolina. Very good morning. Thanks for coming back to the call. I will give you an exec report on your next over. Not very, very strong, but we do have a very quiet frequency at the moment. So hopefully we will be able to make a decent conversation. Anyway, again, Michael, Ocean, Norway, 7, Hotel, Juliet, Alpha, Ambulance, Johan, Juliet, Oscar, Hotel, Alpha. This is the northeast part of Belgium, close to the border of the Netherlands and Germany. Roger.
Roger, Roger, Johan. My name is Gary, Golf Alpha Romeo Yankee, Gary. And I had the pleasure of visiting, not Belgium, but your general area about 2 weeks ago. I was on a cruise that started in Amsterdam, went down the Rhine River to Basel, Switzerland. And then we spent some time on the high-speed trains and went over to Paris and London. Enjoyed your territory for the very first time, but did not quite touch Belgium. Got close, but didn't quite get into that country. You are also not very strong. I'm surprised you were hearing me. You're about S1, but good solid copy. Very low noise level here as well. I'm just running 100 watts. At 100 watts power, the antenna is a Tar Heel Model 200 full-size screwdriver antenna. And I am headed toward the Dayton Hamvention. Back to you, Johan, KN4AQ Mobile.
Roger, Gary, Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec Mobile. This is Alpha 7, Hotel Quebec. I did copy most of it. I do understand that you are on the way to the Dayton Hamvention. 100 watts in the Mobile. Well, on your last over, you were about a 3x0. The S-meter is not moving at all when you are.
I love it. Real signal report.
3x0. Like I said, I do have a very quiet frequency, so I did copy most of it. About a 3x0 on your last over. And, well, I'm glad to hear that you had the opportunity to come to Europe on vacation. If I hear you talking about it, it seems that you saw quite a bit, so I hope that you really had a very, very good time over here. Gary, I am running the FC-2000 from Yaesu. Antenna here is from OptiBeam, OB11-5, about 60 feet high, and right now running about a half a kW into your direction. So that's the story here. Roger.
Okay, Johan, and your signal is getting stronger and stronger, so the band is coming up. 73, KN4AQ Mobile.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.
Well, that was pretty cool. KN4AQ Mobile, I think I heard somebody on 5-2. Yeah, I think it was Tim. My name is Gary, and I'm heading up 77 toward Dayton. You just driving around local, or are you on the road someplace?
I'm on 77 mile marker 44.6, heading south, just going to the Ridge Mountains. So.
Okay, I think we are diverging. I'm at mile marker 73, so I'm on the other mile marker system here in Withville, and we're going to head to opposite directions. Often when I'm making this Dayton trip and I get on 5-2, I'm finding somebody I'm paralleling with and we'll be driving along with for a long time, but I think we're going to be out of range pretty quick.
Yeah, roger that. I think that's the case too. So you're going to Hamvention. I'm just an hour away from Dayton. I never made it there, but I can always go again.
Yeah, you can. Is there a reason why you've opted not to go since you've been so close?
Good question. I got my tickets about 3 years ago, and quite frankly, I felt like I would have been overwhelmed by the experience. It's an odd thing to say. I just got my general this year. I'm really at a point that I could appreciate and make more use of a visit to Hamvention. But this happens to be my camping weekend now.
Okay, well, you got to camp. So, yeah, we're just pulling off the split of 77 and, 81 or something like that, I guess, and head north. So you're holding up longer than I thought at the speed we must be diverging. Let me see what mile marker I'm going to end up at here. It's going to be like 29 or 30, something like that.
Yeah, I'm beginning to think we're actually heading towards each other, honestly.
Yeah, and farther along than I thought. Exit number 41. What mile marker are you at?
I just hit exit 41 on 77. I'm the Kiwi Green Honda Element with a black cargo bag.
There you are. Just passed you.
Yeah, I just saw you, Greg. Crossover?
Yeah, it's a Toyota RAV4 full of antennas. Should stand out pretty well.
Yeah, I caught the antennas.
Yeah, good deal. Well, I guess the weaker signal was just because of the terrain here. So easy to get a whole lot of earth in between us, and we're going to get that effect coming up real quick now.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, I think both you and I read it. We're going to lose each other quickly, but I think that's the case. Yeah, I enjoy getting on the mountain ridges here. I've gotten up to 40 miles simplex right around here.
Yep, you can do that. You can probably do more if you get things just right. Of course, the big problem with the mountains are you can get up high on one mountain, but just down the road there's another mountain.
Yeah, that's exactly the deal. There's actually a pile at Central Ohio that likes to get on 52. So he's been making his rounds on the nice days on the weekends.
A commercial pilot or a private pilot just puttering around in, what do they call them, Piper Cubs?
Yeah, it's just a private plane that he flies around in. A lot of people make contact with them over a big range.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. I have done that, actually, from little planes. I've got a pilot's license. They never expire, but I got it when I was like 19 years old. In 69, and the last time I flew solo was around 1974. But I took radios up in the planes even back then, and had a lot of fun. Some pretty good range. So before we fade out, let me say 73, and enjoy your camping trip. And Dayton is overwhelming, that's for sure, but you can just take, you know, whatever bites you want out of it. Look at all the cool stuff and look at all the strange looking people, and you'll have a good weekend when you try it.
Yeah, the strange looking people made me laugh. I know exactly what you mean. Recently got a Volfang handheld, and some friends of mine work at NASA and have tested out the Volfang. It's a pretty good handheld device, and I know that I've been getting really good distance out of it.
I don't expect that that radio would give you more coverage than a typical radio. There's nothing special about it, but it's good to hear that it's working well for you. I have not tried any of the Chinese handhelds yet. Of course, any handheld that you get these days has got a lot of Chinese stuff in it, but I ought to give that a try. All my handhelds are getting a little old, and they are from the era when you spent hundreds and hundreds of dollars for a handheld radio. You still can, but you don't have to. So I've heard varying reports. I have tried a couple of the mobiles. I reviewed them for QST a couple years ago, and they were unimpressive, but the handhelds seem to be doing better, and they're probably doing better on the mobiles too. So I had to give since they're cheap, I had to give one or two a try and just to see what they're like.
Yeah, for $30, you can't go wrong, right? Yeah, I'm like you. My first one I bought was a Yazoo. I forgot the name, the VX90 or something like that. And I got it because it was waterproof. But for $30 for a Bofang, I can get it wet about every 4 or 5 years.
Yeah, I have actually messed up a radio getting it splashed. It was supposedly not waterproof, but water resistant. And I was on a ride at Disney in Orlando, and it was one of those water rides, and it said, you will get wet, you might get soaked, and I got soaked, and the radio went deaf. So, here comes one of those tunnels. I'm surprised how well our signals have held up and down the ridges in this speed of diverging, but this tunnel is going to kill it. So let me say 73, and have a good weekend. KN4AQ Mobile.
Yeah, good contact, 73KDAQKZ. If you bump into anyone from Delaware, Ohio, they would know of me. Take care.
And he will be gone. Well, that was pretty cool. Normally, when you pick up somebody on 5-2 along this route, they're heading for Dayton. And that's happened starting about this location, but usually maybe a little bit farther along. And unless you're they're really faster than you are, or you're really faster than they are, you end up caravanning for quite a distance. And you can, I can wear myself out of the rag juice, especially since I want to go play with other frequencies. But I suppose we will probably find somebody on 5-2. In fact, I'm almost surprised nobody broke in and said, oh yeah, I'm right behind you and heading for Dayton. And here we are. Just see. Hey Tim, I popped out the other side of the mountain. Are you still hearing me? KN4AQ. Yeah, I didn't think so, because now the mountain is very much in the way. Well, cool. You got to see the tunnel, too. There's going to be one more coming up. I don't, again, won't know if I've got the camera rolling for it or not, but there'll be one more. Those are famous. So, we'll see. I'll just let people know. KN4AQ Mobile, heading for Dayton on I-77, listening 5-2. I suppose I should announce myself now and then, because just like 10 or 15 meters being open and nobody's there, you could have somebody nearby on 5-2, and if neither of you says anything, neither of you will know. I do have, you're hearing APRS in the background. Open the volume on it because I just want to hear what's going on. I don't think I'm close enough to any digipeters for them to pick up my beacons. But I'm also running what they call voice alert.
Is there anybody in here that does not understand what voice alert is when we talk about APRS?
Which means that I've got 100 hertz tone encoded on my 14439 APRS transmission. And my receiver, the volume is up on the APRS channel, but it is tone coded for 100. The idea is if I pass someone else who's beaconing, or I'm paralleling someone else who's beaconing, come into range of them, and they have this 100 hertz tone thing turned on, I will hear their APRS beacon. They may have a text message in their display encoded in their APRS transmission. If they have that and I can look at my display long enough, I can read it. Normally driving along, that's not a good idea. But it could show up and you can list what frequency you're listening to, but I just indicate that I'm listening on 5.2. And I've got the other side of the Kenwood D710 that's doing my APRS, so that always sits on 5.2. With the plethora of radios, and that's one you can't see, it's down there. With the plethora of radios here in the car, I can afford to be monitoring 5.2 all the time.
I was very disappointed. 450 miles, and I made one contact, and it was about 50 miles away.
The veil of clouds and fog and stuff has lifted enough. You can see what kind of terrain that I'm in. So you'd call these mountains. They're not super high mountains. Certainly not the Alps or the Rockies. They're part of the Appalachian chain, and very pretty out here. But it does kind of mess up Simplex mobile to mobile. All right, talked long enough again. Nobody's coming back on me in 5.2. Okay, we'll do a propagation check. Nothing on 20 megahertz.
No space weather storms were observed for the past 24 hours.
WWV is doing their space weather.
24 hours is predicted to be minor. Real magnetic storms reaching the G1 level are minor.
And they are strong. And on 10 megahertz, with the antenna down at 18 megahertz, not real strong, but it's there. Okay. Going to go back into sleep mode for a while. You will wake up instantly and do the Rip Van Winkle thing. I've also got the CB patched in here. One of the, I guess you could call it advantages of the low end of the sunspot cycle. There aren't very many, but if you use Channel 19 as a sort of a traffic spotting and reporting service, which is it is not a very good one. I guess it used to be better. I know it used to be better. When the sunspot cycle is high, you hear signals from all over the country, all over the world, on 27.185. And it's just noisy. So when the sunspot cycle is low, when the band is dead. I wonder if that's a useful report. I don't know what the 23, I don't know where I am. But I don't think it's anywhere near 23. I think I'm in the 60s or 70s. That seems like a long ways away. Anyway, when the band is dead, then you're only hearing local traffic, and it's more likely to be useful. Well, I'm at the 18. Things have changed. I don't know what happened. I guess I'm heading for the 20. Oh, that's right, because I went into West Virginia and it reset. I was seeing the 60s back in Virginia. So there's going to be somebody broke down in the granny lane at the 23. You want to see the guy in the granny lane at 23? Can I banter for that long? It's 3 miles away. Oh, I don't want to be in the granny lane at the 23. I have 3 miles. I guess I could make an edit on our way to the alleged breakdown in the granny lane. Attention, Mark Cartwright. Here on the Dayton 500.
23, you got a broken down truck in the slow lane.
Okay, well. And it's a truck, too. And there's 22 and a half, so it's going to be coming up. Attention, Mark Cartwright. The Dayton 500 is working well with the headset. I guess I'm looking forward to hearing what things sound like. It sounds good in my headphones.
Slow lights broke down.
And there he is. Well, he's
slow lane.
Yeah, he's not totally in the lane, but he's making it useless. I'm listening to the CB on the ICOM 7000, so you can hear it. But down here where you can't see, there is an actual CB radio. I don't have that piped into the audio system.
Going northbound.
The 23, the trailer's sitting at the end of the 23-mile marker.
I think he's at the 23-mile marker. Well, it's about as useful as it gets, and I heard that a couple of miles ahead. And again, if the band were wide open, I wouldn't have. Okay, got to make up some time. Oh, yeah, Mark Cartwright, thank you for helping me get this headset, and it seems to be working. I'm looking forward to hearing what it sounds like in the edit, but it sounds good in my headphones. All right, pushing pause. Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile.
KN4, Alpha, Quebec, great mobile signal. Good work, good afternoon. Come on in.
Good afternoon. Well, I'm glad I caught you in your little extension here. Sorry there's nobody coming on, but I had to make an official check-in to Midcars on the way to Dayton, or it wouldn't be an official trip to Dayton. My name's Gary. I am currently in West Virginia. It's been rainy and overcast, still mostly cloudy, but the rain is gone, and it's about 60 degrees, and on I-77, a little bit south of Beckley, West Virginia, and on the way to Dayton. So thanks for hanging around for a few more minutes. KN4AQ Mobile. It's an ICOM 7000, just 100 watts, and the antenna is a full-size Tar Heel screwdriver.
Oh, man, that setup sounds like a keeper. A great S9 signal coming into Illinois, and it sounds great there, mobile. So, and I believe we're sending some good weather your way, so you ought to have some nice weather there for Dayton. Over.
Yeah, earlier toward the weekend, the forecast didn't look all that good. It looked like it was going to be a lot of rain, and then it all disappeared from the forecast. Hopefully, it will equally disappear from the sky. You know, I haven't been able to hear any of the other last three or four stations that you were working, but your signal is real big here. What part of Illinois are you in?
I'm near Marshall, Illinois. I'm along I-70, just across the state line from Terre Haute, Indiana. Over.
Okay, I'm a former Illinoisian. Being a former Illinoisian, I should know what that word might be, but I don't. Thank you very much. I'm going to drop off here and let you clear. The net may be over. I don't know. This may be it. But it sounds like you needed to get going. So thanks a lot for hanging in there for me. KN4AQ Mobile.
All right, Gary. Well, it's a pleasure. Yep, I've got to go tend to some cows and get ready to drive the bus. I'm not going to be able to stick around. But Gary, great mobile signal. You're going to have some fun with that, I'm sure. And have some fun there in Dayton, by golly. I wish I was going to get you there. So, Gary, 73 to you. Get in here anytime. KN4AQ. We'll clear with that mobile station. Last call for Midcar. So
he's gonna try one more. Let's see if we can hear him. And there he is.
Whiskey 8, Delta Mike Bravo. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Thanks for picking me up. I want to say compliments to that gentleman mobile. He has a great signal. The call is Whiskey 8, Delta Mike Bravo. My name is Dave. I'm located in Bremen, Georgia, which is about 45 miles west of Atlanta, and right by the Alabama line, and both of you guys are coming in here like gangbusters, that's for sure.
Yeah, noise level's dropping, so these guys are sounding stronger.
Thanks for picking me up.
Temperature here today.
Noise is the bane of mobile operation. And I worked that guy in Belgium, you know, with he was giving me a 3-0. And my noise level was about nothing. Well, here on 40, noise levels can get a little higher, although this time of day, not usually. Usually it's also pretty low. But power line noise, local noise is the problem. You drive in and out of it. At least you can drive out of it. If you drive into it and you can keep moving, there's a pretty good chance you'll drive out of it, and usually pretty soon.
Georgia Station, I was able to contact today. So, very good. Hey, get in here anytime and join us. And hey, you might give Gary a call there in that mobile and make some RF up with him. I'm going to have to clear out of here, and I don't think we have a service control coming on. But David, good to hear you.
K9 ARM, Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec Mobile, West Virginia.
KN4 AQ, K9 ARM, go ahead.
Yeah, I don't work too many mobile to mobiles, although not too hard to do here on 40. I'm going up I-77. I'm on my way to Dayton, and you got a real good signal here for a mobile.
Yeah, you do too. Sounding really good. And name here is Andy, and I live northwest of Chicago, but headed for Toledo tonight and probably run down to Dayton for the day tomorrow.
Good deal, Andy. My name is Gary. I'm running 100 watts. The antenna is a full-size Tar Heel, and the radio is an ICOM 7000. What is giving you your big signal mobile?
I'm running a Yaesu 857D and a Tar Heel screwdriver with a homebrew cap hat on a 30-inch whip.
Good deal. I have never tried the capacity hat. I just have the long whip on it. 30-inch whip is real short, but it seems to be working real well for you. You happy with the way that works out, especially on these lower frequencies?
Yeah, absolutely. I drive about 1,000 miles a week, roughly, for work, and have a lot of fun with the radio on the way.
I've got a toll booth coming up here. I got to fish out some money. So let me say 73, and maybe we'll see you at the Big Ham Fest tomorrow. KN4AQ.
Okay, very good. Nice to hear you, Gary. And 73, K9ARM, Mobile, Cleveland.
I'm going to have to do some pilot busting here, and I don't know if I can because the signal's not that strong. Wow. Well, it sounds like a big pileup. It's really two or three stations.
Norway 8, Queen, Germany, Victoria, Quebec, Gulf, Victoria.
I am hearing some lightning crashes, which surprised me. It's the middle of the day on 40 meters. You don't hear that much. At night, you hear a lot. So I looked at the radar, and either my application's not showing me anything or there's nothing around. So I'm not sure where I'm hearing the lightning crashes from.
Kilo 6, Delta, Tango, Tango. Delta, Tango, Tango. You're a 5-9 into New York.
Kilo, Echo 8, Delta, Alpha, Alpha.
Tango, QSL. QSL, thank you for the activation.
Yeah, we're here at Lincoln Boyhood Home, Indiana, Norway Mike 15, QSL.
QSL, you are 5-2 into Kitchener, Ontario, Canada. The name here is Brian, Bravo Romeo, India, Alpha, November. Is your call sign Norway Mike 15?
That's the reference number. My call is Whiskey 7. United Sugar Alpha, Whiskey 7, United Sugar Alpha. The National Park Service reference number is Norway Mike 15, QSL.
Sorry, say again.
I haven't played with the National Parks thing very much at all. I think I might have worked one or two stations. But it seems to be popular. And he's certainly, catching a lot of folks calling him. If he wasn't doing this kind of thing, he wouldn't be getting pileups.
States of America, QSL.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec.
Kilowatt Alpha, 2 Delta.
Yeah, that was badly timed because he was just in the middle of a big fade.
Good afternoon, you're 5-9, Nancy Mike 1-5.
USL, Nancy Mike 1-5, you're 5-9, Arkansas, thank you.
QSL,
thank you. 5-9 in New York. K-A-2-D. 5-9
New York, 73. QSL, 7 United, Sugar Alpha.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec. Yeah, you took a fade. If you're hearing me, you are 5-5, 5-5 in West Virginia. Go ahead. America, Quebec. Alpha, Quebec. Alpha, Quebec. Can barely hear him. Well, that was a surprise. I guess the pileup just disappeared because I don't think he was going to hear me on top of anybody else. Although, you know, that's just judging how he was hearing me based on how I was hearing him. And he gave me a signal report, but it was down in the noise. I couldn't really hear it. I guess he was hearing me okay. I wasn't in the middle of an area that had a lot of local noise. It was just a fade. So, I guess this mobile works better than I thought. And I thought it worked pretty good. So 60 miles away, and
even if nothing else, I guess you don't know the area. Knowing the shortcuts it didn't help you anyway.
Not keying up the 9-4 repeater. It's not a real wide coverage repeater. 9-4 can make APRS go away. 9-4 is the talk-in repeater. It's not by far the widest coverage repeater around Dayton. It's good coverage, and it's got multiple receiver sites. But it peters out at the 40 to 50 mile range. You can see I'm climbing a hill. So maybe I'll give it a kerchunk when I get to the top of the hill. But I think you got to get to the other side of Washington Courthouse before you start really getting into it. I'm sure you're referring to your Google map now.
Monitoring on 52 Simplex, heading toward Dayton. Anybody on frequency?
N8VZ, KN4AQ Mobile, can you hear me now? Wow, he's pegging my meter and he's not hearing me.
You are partly sunny.
Monitoring, anybody on frequency?
Okay, one more try. N8VZ, N8VZ, KN4AQ Mobile on 5-2. Can you hear me?
Yeah, that time I did hear you. I didn't quite catch the call sign. It was kind of picket fencing, but I did hear you in there. Might give the call sign again.
It is Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, KN4AQ, and my name is Gary. Coming up on Washington Courthouse on 35, still a few miles away from that.
Yeah, I think I got that KN4AQ, I think it was. This is November 8, Victor Zulu. Name here is Carl, and I'm a little bit behind you. Looking for a mile marker here. One thing about Simplex, don't have to worry about timing out. Mile marker 13, over.
I didn't even know there were mile markers on the road. I'll have to keep an eye out for it and see where I am. We're probably about 6 miles apart or so. And I have one thing to say. You're late. You were supposed to show up back in West Virginia.
I'm sorry. I kind of didn't get that. I was supposed to show up in West Virginia. Maybe you're being too subtle for me.
Yeah, apologize, I am. Normally I start hearing 5-2 traffic for folks heading into Dayton. somewhere back in West Virginia, even as far south as Charleston. But you're the first one I've heard, and we're almost there.
Oh, okay, I gotcha. Where are you coming from?
Coming from Raleigh, and the name is Gary, Golf Alpha Romeo Yankee, coming from the Raleigh, North Carolina area. I still haven't seen seven? I went by a seven. I don't think that's right as the mile marker, but that's what I just passed.
Okay, yeah, I think the mile markers are going the other way, so I'm a little confused there. Newham in town, who is coming over on Saturday, and I don't think he has any idea what to expect. He was at our little local ham fest, and I don't think he has a good sense as to the the multiplication factor. Aye, over to you.
Camp 4AQ Mobile, I know what you mean. I took a friend to his first Dayton in 2007. We made a video show out of it, and we called him the Dayton Virgin, and he'd been a ham for about 15 years at that point. Been to lots of local ham fests, some of the bigger ones around North Carolina, but he was absolutely blown away. Just couldn't believe the scope. So if you have been coming consistently since the early 90s, I guess you went through the absolute heyday when it reached its peak. I'm told over 30,000 people. It's approaching that again. So I wonder if you remember that, and if you can contrast and compare what it was like then and then a few years later when it fell down, and what it's doing now climbing back up.
Yeah, I can do that. And as we're speaking, I'm just passed by N3UA, I believe it is, who has multiple antennas on his car. He's probably doing HF now or something. I've never really done HF mobile. I've done HF portable, but not mobile too much. At any rate, actually the real decline, I'm trying to get my bearing on the time frame. I don't think it was more than about 10 years ago. They were getting up to, you're right, it was around 35,000 tickets sold. And then it dropped off to a low of, I think, around 19 or 20,000. In the last few years, it's gone back up, and I think the last 2 years it kind of leveled off at somewhere around 24,000, 25,000. The reason for the big decline, in addition to the fact that, you know, you've got more people doing stuff online and things like that, but the reason for the big decline, it got so big they decided, the Dara Club decided that they were going to hire a professional to manage it. Well, the guy they hired turned out to be a thief, and he basically stole a lot of money.
We weren't making money. And to have an event like this, and we were seeing clubs out there, a lot smaller clubs, making money, and we realized that it appeared as though the people that were running the show were running off with the show profits.
Oh, that's pretty serious.
And that was very serious. And we went through a lot of litigation, and I can talk about it now because we had a lock on that for about 5 years.
And also the people he hired to work were not very good at customer service, and they kind of alienated some of the hams that they came in contact with during the hamvention. And so when they finally figured out what was going on and they fired this guy, the last I heard they still had a suit going with him and still had not collected, but I'm a few years off on that, so maybe they finally did. But then the club took back over, and once the club took back over, the organization and running of it, slowly they built up rapport with their fan base, so to speak, again, and it slowly built back up. So that's kind of the story as I know it, over.
Yeah, I appreciate that insight. I think there was more to it than that. I know that happened, and I think that had a big bearing, but Hamfest everywhere took a big hit. It was around the 2002 recession, and the Hamfests everywhere declined, many of them by half or more, and all of them, some of them are struggling back up from that, and some of them are yet to regain much. But I'm sure that was a big part of it. In fact, I've interviewed the former chairman and got some background on that too. But I appreciate your insight. So I am going to get off of here and let the channel go for other folks moving in. And thank you for at least showing up now. I guess you couldn't have shown up in West Virginia because you didn't get on the road until, did you say Akron? I think you said Akron. I'm not sure. It seems like it's a long way north. But I'm glad you did at least, because I'm recording this for my television show, and everyone, I promised everyone folks would show up, and at least finally you did. So thank you very much, and we'll see you at the Hamfest. And I don't remember either your name or your call because my memory works that way, but I am Gary, KN4AQ, and I am just coming into Washington Courthouse.
Yeah, I was just gonna, it's not Akron, Athens, A-T-H-E-N-S, Athens, Ohio, the home of the Ohio Bobcats. Not to be confused with the Ohio State Buckeyes up in Columbus, the junior institution. At any rate, nice talking with you, and appreciate you coming back to me. And KN4AQ, this is N8BZ, and I'll be clear and monitoring. 73.
Cool. So finally, we got our 5-2 guy. That should have happened 100 miles ago. But like I said, I should have been beaconing my existence, and maybe I would have scarfed somebody up who was just driving along listening. But usually, I catch somebody who's already talking. So well, every year is different. Okay, now that I've gone legit, I got my media badge. Those guys are still open. I'm not sure why I thought they closed at 5. But they were still open. Got my badge, got my parking pass, everything's cool. Let me show you how I set up Ham Radio Now episode. I don't know what the episode number is. No, the name of the program, Dayton 500 for the on the road. And then I'm going to go inside and take a look around, and then we'll head back to the hotel. I got a lot of work today. Are you guys ready?
I think we are.
Do you need another week or two?
No, I think we're ready to roll tomorrow.
All right.
Hamvention 2016 is coming real quick.
Well, it's been a long day. It's been a fun day. Lots of interesting activity on the radio. So I hope you enjoyed this version of Ham Radio Now, the Dayton 500 with the new headset. And I got a long day tomorrow, too. I better go to bed. Dinner at my favorite place. I'm Gary Pierce. So, oh, wait a minute. Arvin is left back at the studio. He's always bent out of shape when I do that, but he's fragile. He's a gun, so you know, kind of expensive. I don't want to take him to dangerous places. Anyway, stop by hamradionow.tv if you enjoy the program and you want to help out financially. Even though I went to Europe, I know, getting some heat for that. Still need money. AmRadioNow.tv, and let's go. Well, I'll go to the Hamfest, and you'll watch the video later on. 73, over and out.